This morning, all three scripture lessons urge us to set our hope on heavenly things rather than on earthly things. The Old Testament lesson this morning from Ecclesiastes declares that those who seek lasting peace and happiness on earth in their earthly things will be greatly disappointed. All earthly things will pass away. Only in God can we find that which is good and lasting. The Old Testament lesson is written in the book of Ecclesiastes, the first chapter, the second verse, and also the second chapter beginning at the 18th verse. "Meaningless, meaningless," says the teacher. "Utterly meaningless. Everything is meaningless. I hated all things I had toiled for under the sun, because I must leave them to the one who comes after me. And who knows whether he will be a wise man or a fool? Yet he will have control over all the work into which I have poured my effort and skill under the sun. This too is meaningless. So my heart began to despair over all my toilsome labor under the sun. For a man may do his work with wisdom, knowledge, and skill, and then he must leave all he owns to someone who has not worked for it. This too is meaningless and a great misfortune. What does a man get for all the toil and anxious striving with which he labors under the sun? All his days his work is pain and grief. Even at night his mind does not rest. This too is meaningless. A man can do nothing better than to eat and drink and find satisfaction in his work. This too, I see, is from the hand of God, for without him, who can eat or find enjoyment? To the man who pleases him, God gives wisdom, knowledge, and happiness, but to the sinner he gives the task of gathering and storing up wealth to hand it over to the one who pleases God. This too is meaningless, a chasing after the wind." Here ends the reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. In the epistle, Paul proclaims that we should set our minds on things above, where Christ is at the right hand of God. The epistle lesson for this 11th Sunday after Pentecost is written in the third chapter of Colossians, beginning at the first verse. "Since then you have been raised with Christ, set your hearts on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things. For you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. Put to death, therefore, whatever belongs to your earthly nature: sexual immorality, impurity, lust, evil desires, and greed, which is idolatry. Because of these, the wrath of God is coming. You used to walk in these ways in the life you once lived, but now you must rid yourselves of all such things as these: anger, rage, malice, slander, and filthy language from your lips. Do not lie to each other, since you have taken off your old self with its practices and put on the new self, which is being renewed in the knowledge of the image of its creator. Here there is no Greek nor Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave or free, but Christ is all and is in all." Here ends the reading of the epistle lesson. Please rise for the reading of the Holy Gospel. Christ in the Holy Gospel warns against greed. Our Lord illustrates this truth by telling the parable of the rich fool. The Holy Gospel is written in the 12th chapter of St. Luke, beginning at the 13th verse. "Someone in the crowd said to Jesus, 'Teacher, tell my brother to divide the inheritance with me.' Jesus replied, "Man, who appointed me a judge or an arbiter between you?" Then he said to them, "Watch out! Be on your guard against all kinds of greed. A man's life does not consist in the abundance of his possessions." And he told them this parable. The ground of a certain rich man produced a good crop. He thought to himself, "What shall I do? I have no place to store my crops." Then he said, "This is what I'll do. I'll tear down my barns and build bigger ones, and there I will store all my grain and all my goods. And I'll say to myself, 'You have plenty of good things laid up for many years. Take life easy. Eat, drink, and be merry.'" But God said to him, "You fool, this very night your life will be demanded of from you. Then who will get what you have prepared for yourself?" This is how it will be with anyone who stores up things for himself, but is not rich toward God. Here endeth the gospel.